In this video, we set up Windows Virtual Desktop Monitoring in Log Analytics. Hello everyone, I'm Travis and this is Seraltos. In this video, we're going to go over collecting performance data from Windows Virtual Desktop in Log Analytics and viewing that data with a custom workbook made available from Microsoft. Before that, please take a second to like, subscribe, and click the bell icon for notifications of new content. This video is based off a tech community post from Christiane Brinkhoff. I'll include a link below. This is a great solution Microsoft put together to actively monitor Windows Virtual Desktop services, logins, and session hosts. I'm going to do a walkthrough of setting up the solution, starting with deploying the Log Analytics workspace, then collecting performance data for the servers, and sending Azure Diagnostic data to Log Analytics. Once that's in place, we deploy the workbook to visualize and review the data that gets collected. Let's jump in and get started. Here we are at the portal. The first thing I'm going to do is create a Log Analytics workspace. So let's go to create a resource and Log Analytics. We'll just select this and create. I'll create a new resource group. And I'll call this Demo LARG. I'll give it a name. Let's call it CIR Log Analytics Demo. I'll change the region to Central US. We'll go to the pricing tier. We're going to leave it as pay as you go. I'll leave tags blank, and we'll go to review and create. And I'll give it a minute to finish. That finished, let's go to the resource. Here I am in the Log Analytics demo. Now the first thing I have to do is add the Log Analytics agent to my session host. So to do that, I'll go to the workspace, and then I'm going to go to workspace data source. And select virtual machines. And here we can see the two that I'm going to select are the WVD demo. I'm going to go to the first one and just click connect. And that will deploy the agent to that server and add it to this workspace. Now I'll go to the second one and do the same. Well, that's finishing. The next thing I'm going to do is add the data collection for the session host. So in order to get this solution to work, we have to gather certain performance statistics from these servers to pull them in to Log Analytics. And then the solution will use that data to present the information. I'm just going to open up another window and go to the solution page. And I'll have these links available below. Under Collect Performance Counters, there's a list of two batches of performance counters we have to add. And it's broken into two because Log Analytics can only have like up to, I think it's 20 entries per API call. So they broke this into two set batches. And I'm just going to start with the first one. So I'll copy this. And then I'm going to go to, I'm going to come back up to Advanced Settings. Data, Windows Performance Counters, and I can add that in. Now that will work, but that's a lot of work to go through and add each one individual. So what I did is I created a script, and I'll make this available as well. All I have to do is give it the resource group of that Log Analytics workspace, and then the workspace name. And then I've got a list of all those counters from that website. I just created a list out of that. And this will loop through all of those counters and add it to the workspace. So let's run that. And you do have to be signed into Azure for this to work. Also, you need the AZ module. Let's go and run the script. First, I have to go into the directory. And I'll run the script. This will take a couple seconds to run as it loops through those. I think there's a total of about 36 counters. Adding them one by one certainly can be done. And if you're only doing it once, it's probably not that bad. But I had to do this a few times for this video, so this really helps speed things up. That finished, let's go back to the workspace and see what that looks like. I'm going to just refresh, go back to data and Windows performance counter, and there they all are. Now the next step is to add the Azure AD sign-in logs. So to do that, I'm going to go to Azure AD, and we're going to go to Diagnostic Settings. Diagnostic Settings is interesting because you can use it to push log data to different services. I'm going to add one. I'm going to just give this a name. I'll call it AAD-Diagnostics. I'm going to select Sign-in Logs. Now, notice one thing. You do need an Azure AD P1 or P2 license to collect these logs. If you don't have the license, that's okay. You can skip this step. There's a box that indicates where people are signing in from. That won't work. But otherwise, if you do have Azure AD P1 or P2, you can select this option. And over here, we can send data to Event Hub, Storage Accounts, or Log Analytics. As you might imagine, we want Log Analytics. And we'll go to that CIR Log Analytics demo and click Save. I'm going to go back to Windows Virtual Desktop. I'm going to go to Host Pools, and I have a couple host pools in here. We're just going to focus on this one right now. So every object within Windows Virtual Desktop connected to this host pool, so that includes the host pool, the application groups, and the workspace. I have to do the same thing where I'm going to come into Diagnostic Settings and then add a Diagnostic Settings, check all these boxes, and then send to Log Analytics. But I have to do that for every object, and I'm doing this more than once, so I created another script that will take care of this. Here I'm back in VS Code, and what I need to run the script is I need the host pool name and the host pool resource group. I also need the workspace resource group if it's different from the host pool resource group. They can be in the same resource group, or sometimes a workspace is actually in a different resource group. So if it is different, enter it here, otherwise leave it blank or null, and the script will take care of that. I also need the Log Analytics Workspace resource group and the workspace name. Once I have all that, I can run it, and it's just going to find all the different resource IDs needed, and it will set up the diagnostic settings on all the objects related to that host pool. Again, you have to be logged into Azure AD for this to work, and you need the AZ modules. That finished, let's go to the portal and see what happened. If I come into my workspace and diagnostic settings, here you can see I have diagnostic settings in there now. If I go to that workspace, and my diagnostic settings are in place. We can go into edit settings and see it's sending information to that Log Analytics workspace. Okay, so at this point we have performance monitors collecting on the session host, and we have the diagnostic settings in place for Azure AD sign-in logs, as well as every object related to that host pool. If I was tracking multiple host pools, I'd have to run that again to address those other host pools. Next, we'll create the workbook. Here I am back at the portal, and let's create that workbook. So we're going to go to Log Analytics, go into the workspace we set up in the previous steps, go to Workbooks. I'm just going to move this over, and we're going to add a new workbook. Go to the code. And we need to enter in code here. So to do that, I'm going to come back to this web page. And in the web page under creating a workbook in Azure Monitor, here are all the steps to do it. And I'm going to click on this link to go into the GitHub repository for the code. Here's the code that we need, and I'm going to switch this to raw. And then just copy everything. So I'll do a Control A and a Control C. Now come back to the workbook. And I'll just do a Control A and delete everything out. And then Control V to paste in the code we copied from GitHub. And apply. We've got some options here. Select your subscription. And I'm going to select the workspace. Next, go to resource group. And I'll select the resource group that my host pool is in. And then I'll select the host pool. And I've got a couple here, but select the one that you applied those performance counters to. And then under hosts, I'll select all. Next, I'm going to select done editing. And save. I'm going to change the name. And click save. So next time we come in, if we go to our workbooks, we can see our recent modified workbook. That's right here. Now we can take a look at some of the data that came through. Notice that it defaults to the workspace that we set up before we saved it, but you can modify that if you need. In the Overview tab, we have Windows Virtual Desktop resources, daily connections, current status. We've got a login heat map, so you can see where logins are coming from. We've got average session duration by users. We've got a whole bunch of good information here. Then we can go to session detail and get details on each session. Session overview and history. I don't have a lot of data displaying here because this is a test workspace. But it gives you an idea of the type of information you can get from this solution. Here it looks like I have some errors, connection errors. And it gives a list of the connection errors. Looks like the numbers are crowded there. But you get the idea. We get a lot of information from this. Here, if I change this name to So if I change it to my name, the user I'm using to log in, I can see some details about my connections. We have session performance. And host performance. Here you can get details about each host. That's an overview of the Windows Virtual Desktop workbook solution. In this demo, we deployed a Log Analytics workspace. We added session hosts to the workspace and set up the data collector, as well as adding Windows Virtual Desktop diagnostic data and Azure AD SignIn diagnostic data. We then created and saved the workbook and reviewed the information we got from that workbook. I hope you found that helpful. I want to thank Christiane Brinkhoff and the rest of the contributors at Microsoft for making the solution available. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and all that good stuff. Thanks for watching.